Hello, and welcome to the Open Virtual Film Project. In this video, I will be showing you how to install the Epic Games Launcher and the version of the Unreal Engine that we are going to be using for this class. If you already have the Epic Games Launcher and Engine version 4.26 or later installed, feel free to skip this video. Alright, right into it. The first thing you're going to want to do is go to the Unreal Engine webpage, and in the top right-hand corner, there will be a download button. There's going to be a link to this webpage in the description. Once you've clicked the download page, you're going to scroll down and choose a license. For this series, we're going to be using the creator's license since we're using this for education. However, if you're using this for another reason, take a look at the differences between the two licenses and choose which one most appropriately fits your project. So we're going to click the download button. It's going to download the Epic installer. Once the Epic installer has downloaded, we're going to click onto it and follow the steps to download the Epic installer. Once it's downloaded, you're going to want to open it up, and it'll give you a sign-in page. If you already have an Epic Games account, click whatever method you used to sign up for your Epic Games account. Or if you do not have an Epic Games account yet, click the Sign Up button at the bottom. Once you're all signed in, you're going to want to go to the Unreal Engine tab on the left, and click on the Library tab. Inside of this tab, you'll find the versions of the engine that you're working with, any projects that you have created, as well as a vault of plugins that you have installed into your Epic Games library. As you can see, I already have Unreal version 4.26.2 installed on my computer, which is the version we're using for this class. However, if I did not, I would click this plus button here, go over to the new tab that it created, click the dropdown, and select my engine version from this dropdown here, and click the install button. At which point it will prompt me for an install location. I want this install location to be on a solid state drive on my computer if I can manage it. It does not matter if that's the C drive or a secondary drive you have added to your computer. I would not install the engine version onto an external hard drive. If you are tight for space, you can install the actual projects that we will be creating on an external drive. All right, I'm going to click the install button and wait for it to install. And that is it for this video. Thank you for watching.